Access to Medicaid comes at a cost. That's what some Missouri lawmakers are saying after 53% of Missouri voters said yes to Amendment 2. Today, we're learning how local health providers feel about this, along with how Medicaid expansion could impact taxpayers. Color 10's David Chasanov joins us live from Mercy. David, how will this affect the hospital?
Well, Heather, as a local faith-based healthcare provider, Mercy has always treated its patients regardless of their ability to pay. President Craig McCoy tells me the hospital will likely see less ER visits since many low-income families have used the emergency room to go see a primary care doctor in the past. Now, today I also spoke with Citizen Memorial Hospital's director of reimbursement. He tells me Amendment 2 passing is a win all around.
Was a long battle.
Tim Walter says since the Affordable Care Act passed, CMH has sent money to Washington.
Right now we're sending about $3.5 million each year in the form of Medicare cuts. It's nice to finally get some of that money to come back to Missouri now.
Medicaid expansion will cover most procedures at CMH, and it allows more patients between ages 19 and 64 to see a primary care doctor. A single person making less than $17,000 a year would be eligible. For a couple, it's about $23,000 or less. The income threshold goes up for families with kids. The larger the family, the higher the income threshold.
Patients will have coverage. They'll have better access to health care. We will be able to take care of them at the right time, help them manage their conditions, keep them healthier. The jobs is certainly something to consider as far as the economic impact on the state.
Republican State Representative Hannah Kelly says she doesn't think this will be good for the state's economy. She says projections show Amendment 2 costing Missouri $349 million of its general revenue.
Any projections most often are wrong, and it's always cost us more.
Kelly says Missourians can expect to see cuts in education, infrastructure, and even a rise in taxes. She says she doesn't know how high taxes could get.
What scares me more than anything and why I've been against this from day one is there's no quantifiable individual amount that I can point to as a guide for what to expect. To me, that's very, very scary as a Missouri citizen. Taxpayer and as a state representative. It's why I fought against it hard.
So here's how Medicaid works. States pay money to the federal government for Medicaid, and from there the federal government distributes that money to states implementing Medicaid expansion. Now that Amendment 2 is passed, Missouri will soon be part of that list come July 1st of 2021, meaning they will be getting more money for health care. Reporting here in Springfield, David Chasanoff, Ozarks First.